Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel Dental Cafe. Today I'm going to discuss about the dentigerous cyst or follicular cyst. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon for the latest video. Okay then, let's begin the video. What is dentigerous cyst? Odontogenic cysts that surround the crown of the impacted tooth caused by fluid accumulation between reduced enamel epithelium and the enamel surface. Look at the figure. This is impacted third molar, which is surrounded by a cyst. As you can see in figure. Okay, let's understand in detail. This is hard tissue or impacted third molar crown, which is surrounded by a membrane that is reduced enamel epithelium. In between reduced enamel epithelium and the crown of the impacted third molar, fluid is present, which result in formation of cyst, as you can see in figure, and crown is in the lumen of the cyst. And one more thing which you have to notice, that cyst is attached to the CEJ. Epidemiology. Second most common odontogenic cyst after that of periapical cyst. Age 2nd to 4 decades of life, and uncommon in children as third molar are absent in children's. Look at the figure. This is third molar, and apices of the third molar cyst is present, which is called periapical cyst. This is the first most common odontogenic cyst, and after that dentigerous cyst is the second most common odontogenic cyst. Do remember. As we know, this is third molar, which is surrounded by reduced enamel epithelium. So how actually cyst is formed, we will understand under pathology. Dentigerous cyst is formed by the hydrostatic force exerted by the accumulation of fluid between reduced enamel epithelium and the tooth crown of unerupted teeth. As you can see in figure, fluid exerts outward pressure. So you have to remember two points. First is hydrostatic force, and second is cyst is associated with crown of unerupted or impacted teeth, mainly third molar. Cyst encloses the crown and is attached to the neck at the cemento-enamel junction. As you can see, the pressure exerted by the fluid result in the formation of cyst. And cyst is always attached to the CEJ of the tooth. Now, the important note, that common in mandible as compared to maxilla, most commonly involved teeth are mandibular third molar is the most common, after that maxillary third molar, after that maxillary canine, then mandibular second premolar. And yeah, this is very important point, that dentigerous cysts are usually solitary, maybe multiple in case of basal cell nevus syndrome. How you will differentiate dentigerous cyst with other cyst? So on the basis of cystic contents, we will differentiate dentigerous cyst with other cyst. Look at the figure. It contains clear yellow fluid and white cholesterol crystals. As you can see, consists of clear yellow fluid in which cholesterol crystals may be present, and in long standing cases pus may be present. What are the symptoms? Smaller cysts are asymptomatic. If size is less than 5 mm, then it is called follicle. If greater than 5 mm, then called dentigerous cyst. Symptom shows by larger cyst is swelling, tooth sensitivity, tooth displacement. How dentigerous cyst is diagnosed? It is diagnosed by dental X-ray, OPG, CT, that is computed tomography, MRI. Look at the figure. This is OPG, and yellow dotted line represents dentigerous cyst. You have all these options to diagnose dentigerous cyst, but confirmation is on the basis of cystic content. Radiographically, three variants of dentigerous cyst are seen. First one is circumferential, second one is lateral, and third one is coronal or central. Look at the figure. This is impacted third molar, and that yellow shaded area represents circumferential cyst. Then this is lateral variant of dentigerous cyst, and the last one is central or coronal variant of dentigerous cyst. Here you have to notice one thing, that in all the cases of dentigerous cyst, cyst is attached at the CEG. Look at the figure. This is not a dentigerous cyst. This is a other type of cyst. How is it treated? We have two methods. First one is enucleation for small cyst. In this, complete removal of cyst is done, and this can be done by curettage or blind section of cystic lining. Firstly, remove the bone over the cyst. Now cyst is visible. Once cyst is visible, remove it completely. This is enucleation. Second method is marsupialization. Marsupialization is for large cyst. It is creating a surgical window in the wall of the cyst, evacuating content of the cyst, and maintaining continuity between cyst and the oral cavity, maxillary sinus, or nasal cavity. Window is created, then suture the cystic lining with oral mucosa and evacuate cystic content. As the cystic content is evacuated, pressure inside the cystic cavities decreases. So we have two methods. First one is enucleation and second is marsupialization. What are the complications associated with cyst? Infection, tooth loss, jaw fracture, ameloblastoma. It is jaw tumor. Look at the figure. If third molar is removed or lost, there is a chances of jaw fracture in case of dentigerous cyst. And ameloblastoma is most common complication associated with untreated dentigerous cyst. Differential diagnosis of dentigerous cyst. First one is periapical cyst or radicular cyst, aneurysmal bone cyst or ABC, ameloblastoma, odontogenic keratocyst or OKC, cherubrism or fibrous dysplasia, Stephne cyst. Don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for the latest videos. Thank you for watching.